welcoming him right to the canvas.
Oh, this is interesting. This is different.
Shugars looks excited about the opportunity here.
Oh, well, Shugars does have an amateur wrestling background. Not as decorated, I'd say, as Tavion Heights.
Having a difficult time moving it out. They've been here.
This wasn't a good idea by Shugars early on.
Shugars a bit overzealous in his NXT debut.
This is a little uncomfortable to watch.
And look at the power and strength here. Look at those rotations, Byron.
Tavion Heights making it look easy. We saw some early mind games from Shugars. Those mind games are long gone.
Ooh!
Unreal.
As Tavion Heights, as Byron, it looks like the confidence is sky high as ever.
What I tell you, Olympia. Sometimes all it takes is one win to completely alter your mindset, and I think that's what's happened to Tavion Heights.
And Byron, we talked about the last time here on Level Up where he was able to get by Dante Chen. What did Tavion Heights prove to himself with that victory?
He proved to himself that he can learn from defeat, he can fix his mistakes, and he can come back better. That's the key to having a successful career.
As Saquon Shugars right now getting run ragged here by Tavion Heights.
Trying to get some escape and creatively does.
Heads up move there by Saquon Shugars. I had an opportunity to talk to Saquon here earlier today, and he's a big advocate of mind games for success. And you have to wonder, how will that translate here inside the ring in NXT? And you have to wonder, did that help him prepare for Tavion Heights in his debut?
Well, question. He actually walked onto that team. It just shows you, how adaptable Shugars is, and he has completely taken control of this match.
Much of the chagrin here of the NXT universe. As Shugars, innovative offense, bringing it here right to Level Up. Into the cover, Shugars looking to make this first match a sweet victory. And Tavion able to hang on.
It is such a special time of year. You make memories that are going to be remembered for a lifetime. Everyone's in the best shape of their careers. Newest gear. The lights are the brightest. It is an unforgettable stage.
Certainly when everybody ups their ante to the highest level, as Tavion Heights looks to continue his rise in NXT.
The thing with Tavion Heights we've seen over the last year is that he has the ability, oh my goodness, as intense as he is, he finds a way to upgrade that intensity mid-match.
When we talk about that professional rodeo career, Byron, how do you transition from wrangling bulls to wrangling superstars?
As I kind of mentioned earlier, you're used to the aggression of others. You're used to having to stabilize your body. You're used to have to deal with the unpredictable. That's what these parts are all about.
Stepping into the ring here against Jaida Parker, who essentially put Adriana Rizzo on the shelf, got by Gigi Dolan. You have to wonder, how much confidence does Jaida Parker have?
Jaida Parker has been the difference maker for OTM, as I mentioned, but Jaida Parker has also turned a lot of heads in a short amount of time. Remember, it was Jaida Parker who approached OTM and said, you need me.
This is true.
You need me to get back on your game.
She stepped up to the plate looking to take them to the next level. Here is Lainey Reed, who looks to embrace her culture and bring that in here to the ring. You have to wonder, almost has that Southern charm translate in the squared circle.
Reed's the kind of girl that invites you over for sweet tea. With some hot biscuits. By the way, sweet tea, one of my favorite wrestlers ever. Great dancer, even better commentator.
Just thinking more of a drink, nonetheless. From the outside in, Lainey Reed into the cover. Just looking to shot Jaida Parker early on here as Lainey Reed looks to stay on the offense.
Now, we always like to ask the what if. What if someone who's making their debut, i.e. Lainey Reed, upsets Jaida Parker? And you think about what OTM has been through. Bronco Nima, Lucian Price suffered a hiccup a couple weeks ago.
Here's Reed into the cover.
And their tag team title pursuits. So for Jaida Parker, this is a chance to continue that momentum, or it gets stunted even further.
And of course, Jaida Parker coming into this matchup, having some success here at NXT, but Jeff has to wonder, how does she really prep for that unknown?
Sometimes you just have to trust your instincts.
And Parker really starting to light up Lainey Reed here, as Lainey Reed getting into deeper waters that she's never been in before.
And when you make your debut, you deal with the nerves, you deal with the excitement, you get yourself all hyped up before you walk out that curtain. That adrenaline is flowing a couple minutes into the match, but then you settle into, a moment like this, where it's gut check time, where you have to figure out, can you survive in the deep waters against a more experienced opponent?
Sneaking behind referee Jeremy Marcus right here is
still talking that talk.
And that's what she will do. She'll talk the talk and walk the walk. As right now, Jaida Parker looking to maybe end things, but Lainey Reed very feisty in this one. Inside cradle, Lainey Reed has the shoulders down. And Lainey trying to stay alive in this matchup here.
Credit to Lainey Reed for hanging in there, trying to find some. Oh, that was a nasty left hand by Lainey Reed.
Certainly unexpected there. And Lainey Reed, again, not afraid to get tough and dirty here.
You have no choice when you're in with a competitor like Jaida Parker. She brings you to that place.
Is Underground now Eddy Thorpe's new signature?
I think you have to say it is. I mean, as far as the history books are concerned, the NXT Underground match is synonymous with Eddy Thorpe. And that's a badge that he'll wear with honor.
Indeed it is, and Uriah Connors here, feeling it from the NXT Universe right now, and you mentioned that appearance against Sean Spears in his official debut. How did Spears fuel the fire of Connors here tonight as he looks to get back on track?
Really compelling. I spoke to Uriah Connors for about 5 minutes about that match, and he said it only ignited his fire. As soon as that match was over, he wanted to step back in that ring and have another match, and compete a little harder, get more physical. So while that match might have broken some competitors, it only helped Uriah Connors focus.
A picture-perfect dropkick right there by Uriah Connors, sending Eddy Thorpe to the outside. And now Connors might just start to see a little bit of daylight right now. And Connors flies right through there with the tope suicida.
I like this. I always say, look, what you did prior to your NXT WWE career, it helps you fill the early stages. But how do you grow from that?
As Thorpe here into the cover. And we know how hard Eddy Thorpe hits, of course, spent a lot of time over Japan, utilized that strong style a lot, and that has really separated him from a lot of the competitors here in NXT.
And speaking of growing, Eddy Thorpe did that. A much heralded debut, a lot of hype when he came into NXT, but he built on that hype. He showed this audience, this crowd, what he could do.
And Thorpe into the cover, hooks the outside leg.
And as a result, he has earned their respect.
As these two going back and forth right in the center of the ring here. And Connors, takes down Eddy Thorpe. And Uriah Connors starting to build a little bit of momentum here, Byron.
Uriah Connors displaying his resiliency, his ability to absorb punishment. Still favoring his chest, but still fighting.
And Connors now with some big strikes in the corner. Blue Thunder Bomb. Could this do it, Byron? The first win of Uriah Connors' career will not come yet.
And this is always that moment of the match where you start looking around, you start questioning yourself. Uriah Connors cannot afford to doubt himself right now.
Let's take another look right here. Look at the rotation here. Taking Eddy Thorpe, spinning him around and putting him right down. And Uriah Connors busting out all kinds of offense in his Level Up debut. As Eddy Thorpe tries to counter of his own here. Oh! And Connors, gets dropped right down by Eddy Thorpe. And Thorpe, he's starting to feel it, Byron.
You can see it on the face of Eddy Thorpe right now. He's ready to put this thing away. He is ready to finish off Uriah Connors.
He gets into the position there, and boom! The Impaler DDT, and Eddy Thorpe is back!